lectures. And then he knew, after listening to those, that something was vastly wrong in that church, and they were indeed getting away from the teachings of Herbert W. Armstrong. I got fired in his sophomore year, so at the end of that sophomore year, he too decided that he would return home and take a stand with me on those key issues. Now, we certainly were devastated by what happened in the Worldwide Church of God, but it was not because of any change in leadership after Mr. Armstrong died. We were devastated because they were destroying the very work that Mr. Armstrong had established. And that's what painfully upset all of us.
The cabal of leaders who took control of the church he founded, after pledging to follow in his footsteps, set out to methodically destroy all that he had built. Those who would stop them were silenced or excommunicated. Now, 20 years after the death of its founder, Worldwide Church of God membership ranks have dwindled by about 75%. The income has plummeted by about 95%. The World Tomorrow program vanished from the airwaves in 1994. Ambassador College, providing liberal arts training to some 15,000 students over five decades, is now closed. The Good News was discontinued in 1990, while The Plain Truth barely survives with a few thousand subscribers. All the unique doctrines of the Worldwide Church of God have been changed. All of Mr. Armstrong's literature has been retired. All the operations he established have been either drastically downsized or phased out altogether. This shocking story of betrayal and deception is vividly retold by Gerald Flurry's son in his new book, Raising the Ruins, now available in bookstores. Finally, you can know the truth about what happened to the Worldwide Church of God after the death of Mr. Armstrong. It truly is the most astonishing story in modern religion. Contact your local bookstore today and request Raising the Ruins by Stephen Flurry. For more information, visit www.raisingtheruins.com. In the final year of his long, productive life, Herbert W. Armstrong completed the best work of his 93 years of life, the book Mystery of the Ages.
When the Bible speaks, that is God speaking, not a man. Now, it's true, Moses wrote the first five books, but it wasn't really Moses writing it. God was having him write it, and it was God writing it, but that was really inspired. And then when we come to prophets like Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, then when we come to the New Testament books, God inspired them. They are the infallible words of God. This book is not. I don't make any such claim for this book whatsoever. But I think in a way God inspired it, but not in the sense that it is the Word of God. It's as God inspired Herbert Armstrong. And I tried to yield myself to him, and I hope I was able to yield myself, if not 100%, 97%, 98%, 99%. The Bible is like a book that had been sort of cut up into about 2,000 or 3,000 pieces, and you have to get them all put together in the right order, or you can't understand them. This book puts them together. And yet this book is only a synopsis. You could say it's the gist of the Bible. The synopsis, it doesn't cover all of it, but it covers the main thread of the Bible so you can understand the Bible and understand the other details when you read them in the Bible. It'll open up the Bible so that you understand it. That's what it is for. Make the Bible plain and clear and understandable. And God is such a great God when you come to really know Him and who and what He is and how real He is. And I want to say that you need to read every word and you need to go over it more than once. You aren't going to get the full meat of this book in one reading. This is a book that after you've read it, you can read it a second time and then later a third time. This book is not intended to take the place of the Bible. It's intended to make it so that you will understand the Bible. You must read the Bible with it. And this is to make the Bible clear and understanding to you as you read it and bring its meaning out as you never saw it before. And I hope it'll be a blessing to you. I hope you will enjoy it. It'll give you great happiness and enjoyment. I hope you'll enjoy reading it. And I hope more than any other book you've ever read, except the Bible. And perhaps, in a sense, this makes even the Bible more clear and plain, and you'll enjoy the Bible more from now on. Will you forgive me if I get a little bit of thrill that this was then done? Book is out now. Today is a pretty big day in my life, when I can hand the copies of this book out to each of you.
Mr. Armstrong was intent on reaching the largest audience possible with the book. And indeed, the book quickly became the most popular, fastest-moving publication the Worldwide Church of God ever produced. But when Joseph DeCotch took over for Mr. Armstrong in 1986, his administration rejected Mr. Armstrong's teachings, stopped distributing Mystery of the Ages, and even destroyed its remaining inventory of the book. 120,000 copies were thrown out. But beginning in 1989, the same God who raised up Herbert W. Armstrong's work went to work raising the ruins. And by 1997, the scattered remains of those who held to their original faith had grown in number to support an exciting new phase of God's work, reprinting and sending Mystery of the Ages to the largest audience possible. Immediately, the same leadership that cut down Mr. Armstrong came gunning for this resurrected work, promising to destroy the book again, saying it was their Christian duty to keep this book out of print. A grueling life and death 6-year copyright battle ensued, in which the Worldwide Church of God and the Philadelphia Church of God went head to head over the body of beliefs outlined in Mystery of the Ages. The history of this amazing case and its wondrous outcome shines a stark light on what really happened inside the Worldwide Church of God. Relying on a wealth of official WCG documents and depositions submitted in federal courts, Raising the Ruins reveals the truth behind the shipwreck of the Worldwide Church of God and outlines the almost unbelievable twists and turns of this unprecedented legal battle.
I think that when this lawsuit started, the Worldwide Church of God thought that, well, we'll immediately take them to court, we'll get the judge to issue a restraining order, the Philadelphia Church of God will have to stop distributing Mystery of the Ages, as simple as that. But it wasn't as simple as that. In fact, at the very first hearing, before we even had the opportunity to prepare a defense, really, the judge looked at their attorneys and essentially said, I think you're going to lose this case. And that just sent them reeling. You mean we're going to have to litigate this? And yes, they were going to have to litigate this. And so the door cracked open, and we were granted access to these internal documents that have to be turned over in